I hope you had a blessed Sabbath.
Ich hoffe, dass ihr einen gesegneten Sabbat gehabt habt.
Let's open with a prayer.
Lasst uns jetzt mit Gebet sein.
Dear Heavenly Father,
lieber himmlischer Vater,
we thank you for the Sabbath.
Wir danken dir für den Sabbat.
And we thank you for this new week.
Wir danken dir jetzt für diesen neuen Wochen.
And we ask that you please give us fresh revelation from your word.
Und wir bitten, dass du uns jetzt eine frische Offenbarung deines Wortes gibst.
That we can start this new week with thoughts from your word.
Dass wir diese Woche neu anfangen können mit Gedanken aus deinem Wort.
And that you impart us the oil for the trials of this week.
Und dass du uns den Öl geben mögest für die Versuchungen und Schwierigkeiten dieser Woche.
And we thank you already for your mercy and for the grace you bestow upon us.
Und wir danken dir für deine Gnade und für deine Erbarmen und deine Gnade, die du über uns gibst.
And we ask and pray all these things in Jesus' name.
Und wir beten all dies in Jesu Namen.
Amen.
Amen.
So, this evening we will look at the 1000 years.
So heute Abend wir werden das Thema der 1000 Jahren anschauen.
And I post some notes
es
in the live stream.
Notizen in den Livestream, in Englisch und Deutsch.
Somewhere in between the
Die sind genau inmitten der Lieder zu finden.
Okay. Just grab one or two songs, it should be there. Okay, so everybody found the notes?
Jeder die Notizen gefunden?
Okay. So, here, the upper line.
So, hier auf den oberen Linie.
The upper line. This one.
Also, auf dieser Linie.
Okay, let me just quickly put this down here. Okay, so what we have here is basically the biggest fractal that can be there.
Also hier oben haben wir der größte Fraktal, die wir je benutzen.
Okay, because in the first box, that's basically from the Sunday law, from the first Sunday law, down to the literal second coming of Christ.
So das erste Kasten hier ist der erste Sonntagsgesetz bis zu das buchstäbliche zweiten Kommen.
So basically, this one would be the close of probation for all mankind.
So hier wäre das Schluss der Gnadenzeit für die alle Menschen.
And we understand the seven last plagues begin to fall, but there's a little time of peace, right?
Wir verstehen, dass die sieben Plagen fingen an hier zu fallen, aber es gibt zuerst diese kleine Zeit des Friedens.
So, and then they make a death decree.
Dann machen sie ein Todesdekret.
And this marks the beginning of what time?
Und das markiert das Anfang von welcher Zeit?
Jacob's Trouble.
Yes, Jacob's Trouble. So,
der Trubel von Jakob.
So,
Jakob's Trouble.
Jacob's Trouble. And then we understand right here at the end of the seven last plagues, at the seventh plague, they get delivered. Right?
Und wir verstehen, dass hier am Ende der sieben Plagen, bei der siebten Plage, sie werden befreit.
Okay, and then basically at the end of the seventh plague, Jesus comes.
Am Ende der siebte Plage kommt Jesus.
And he takes now all those redeemed ones up to heaven for the 1000 years.
Und okay. Er nimmt all diese Erlösten mit sich in den Himmel für 1000 Jahre.
Okay, and then eventually he will come and execute the judgment on the wicked at the end of the 1000 years.
Und am Ende des 1000 Jahren wird er wiederkommen und das Gericht aus dem Bösen ausführen.
Okay, and this is what we want to look at a little bit closer this evening.
Und das ist es, was wir heute Abend etwas ein bisschen näher betrachten wollen.
And there are some points that I'm still not 100% sure yet, but doesn't matter, we will just look and take what we can already understand.
Und es gibt einige Punkte, über die ich immer noch nicht 100%ig sicher bin, aber nichtsdestotrotz werden wir das nehmen, was wir sehen können.
Okay, so let us begin with a quote here about the seventh plague.
So wir fangen an hier mit einem Zitat über der siebte Plage.
And I think we are quite familiar with this one already.
Wir sind relativ bekanntes Zitat.
Okay. It is at midnight that God manifests his power for the deliverance of his people. The sun appears shining in its strength. Signs and wonders follow in quick succession. So when does the Lord deliver them?
So wann befreit der Herr sein Volk?
Says here at midnight.
Am Mitternacht.
Okay, so let's continue.
Lass uns weiterführen.
The wicked look with terror and amazement upon the scene, while the righteous behold with solemn joy the tokens of their deliverance. Who is this?
So, über wen spricht das hier?
The tokens of their deliverance.
So, diese Zeichen ihrer Befreiung?
Cyrus. Yes, Cyrus, right?
So, Kyros.
Cyrus coming through the gates of Babylon.
So, Kyros, der durch die Pforten Babylons.
Yeah, because then the deliverance was drawing nigh, right?
Und dann ihre Befreiung.
Okay. Everything in nature seems turned out of its course. The streams cease to flow. Dark, heavy clouds come up and clash against each other. In the midst of the angry heavens is one clear space of indescribable glory, whence comes the voice of God like the sound of many waters, saying, "It is done." Revelation 16, verse 17. Okay. So let's remind ourselves. Let's turn to Revelation 16, verse 17.
Lasst uns zur Erinnerung. So, Offenbarung 16, Vers 17 geht.
Let's read verse 17. It says, "And the seventh angel poured out his vial into the air, and there came a great voice out of the temple of heaven from the throne, saying, it is done." Right? So, when the voice comes to deliver them, saying it is done, what is it?
Also, wenn die Stimme kommt und sagt, es ist getan, was ist das? Deliverance.
Yes, but which? The seventh plague, yes.
Also, sie befreien, aber es ist der siebte Plage.
Yes.
Amen.
Okay. And Sister White says, it is?
And White sagt, es ist?
Midnight, right?
Mitternacht.
Okay. So therefore, when the seventh plague comes,
so wenn der siebte Plage kommt,
it says it's midnight.
Sagt,
okay.
Dass es Mitternacht ist.
Okay, so midnight begins. Therefore, that's just another proof to show that the beginning of the ten is also already midnight.
Das ist nur ein weiteres Beweis, um zu zeigen, dass das Anfang des Zehnes ist bereits Mitternacht.
Yes.
Amen.
Okay. So midnight and midnight.
So, Mitternacht und Mitternacht.
Okay. So. And it's the seventh plague, and then let's read the next boldface in the next paragraph.
So, es ist auch der siebte Plage. Lasst uns den fettgedruckten in den nächsten Absatz lesen.
Then it says, this voice that says it is done, it says, that voice shakes the heavens and the earth. So, when it says it is done here.
So, wenn es sagt, es ist getan hier.
What does it do?
Was tut das?
Yes.
So, erschüttert den Himmel und Erde.
So, heaven plus earth. Shake.
So, Himmel und Erde erschüttert.
Okay. And this would be, yeah, when we take this fractal and stretch it out here.
So, wenn wir diesen Fraktal nehmen und es hier unten ausdehnen.
Would be here, right?
Werde hier denn sein.
Yeah, so, the death decree is here. And this would be here.
Tote Dekret, hier am Ende.
Okay, so, just the same. Heaven plus earth, shaken. Yeah. Not German, but English. Okay, so, thus far everybody can follow?
So, kann jeder soweit folgen?
Yes, okay. So, now let's jump down to the next paragraph.
So, nächster Absatz.
It says, graves are opened, and many of them that sleep in the dust of the earth awake, some to everlasting life, and some to shame and everlasting contempt. Daniel 12, 2. All who have died in the faith of the third angel's message come forth from the tomb glorified, to hear God's covenant of peace with those who have kept his law. They also which pierced him, Revelation 1:7, those that mocked and derided Christ's dying agonies, and the most violent opposers of his truth and his people, are raised to behold him in his glory and to see the honor placed upon the loyal and obedient. Okay, so what does it mark here? What happens here at the beginning of the seventh plague?
Was markiert das hier? Was fängt an am Anfang der siebten Plague?
It's a resurrection, right?
Auferstehung.
And what kind of resurrection is this?
Und was für eine Auferstehung ist das?
The special resurrection.
Yeah. Besondere oder Sonderauferstehung.
Okay, right. And some of the righteous get raised up here, right?
Einige von den Gerechten werden hier auferweckt.
And those that died in the faith of the third angel's message,
die,
right?
Die im der Glaube an der dritte Engelsbotschaft gestorben sind.
But who else gets raised up here?
Aber wer noch?
Yes, but how, what wicked? All wicked or?
Welche von den größten Bösen? So die größte Gegner.
So wicked. Raised up, but it says especially those that pierced him, right?
Also die Bösen werden oft erweckt hier, aber besonders diejenigen, die ihn durchbohrt haben.
So that pierced him, and it's quoted Revelation 1:7.
Und es zitiert Offenbarung 1, Vers 7.
Okay. So now let's continue.
So weiter.
Now we come to this quote about the 1,000 years.
Jetzt kommen wir zu Zitat über 1,000 Jahre.
Okay, but in this quote she first speaks about this time period here, okay?
Aber in diesem Zitat, sie spricht zuerst über diesen Zeitperiode.
About the seven plagues.
Über die sieben Plagen.
Which is in this illustration this year.
Was auf dieser Linie wäre denn hier?
Okay. So, let me just write it down. Okay. Okay, so let's see what she writes here.
So, lasst uns schauen, was sie schreibt.
Says, then I saw that after Jesus leaves the sanctuary, the plagues will be poured out. So Jesus leaves the sanctuary here at the close of human probation, right?
So Jesus verlässt den Heiligtum hier bei dem Schluss von menschlichen Gnaden. So.
And then it says, said the angel, it is the wrath of God and the Lamb that causes the destruction or death of the wicked. So when these seven last plagues are poured out, what happens with the wicked? So
wenn diese sieben letzten Plagen ausgegossen werden, was geschieht mit den Bösen?
They get destroyed, right? They die.
Sie werden zerstört.
Okay.
Kommen um.
Yeah, and we understand when Jesus appears here, what happens?
Und wir wissen, dass wenn Jesus hier erscheint, was geschieht?
I'll just go to Revelation 19.
Offenbarung 19.
And let's read verse 11 and verse 21.
Vers 11 und Vers 21.
So Revelation 19 verse 11 it says, and I saw heaven opened, and behold a white horse, and he that sat upon him was called faithful and true, and in righteousness he doth judge and make war. Okay, so this marks the second coming of Christ, right?
Das markiert das zweite Kommen.
Yeah, when he comes with a white horse.
And
now verse 21.
Jetzt Vers 21.
And the remnant was slain with the sword of him that sat upon the horse, which sword proceeded out of his mouth, and all the fowls were filled with their flesh. So when he comes, all the wicked die. Right?
So wenn er kommt, alle Bösen kommen um.
Okay. So all wicked die. Okay, so this is already. Okay, let's go now to Jude. Jude 1.
So lass uns zu Judas Brief gehen. Judas 1.
And then verse 14 to 15.
Die Verse 15, 14 und 15.
It says, and Enoch also, the seventh from Adam, prophesied of these, saying, behold, the Lord cometh with 10,000s of his saints. So what is it describing here in verse 14?
So, was wird hier in Vers 14 beschrieben?
Yeah, second coming, right?
Sein zweites Kommen.
When he comes with the 10,000, with all his angels, right?
Er kommt mit den 10,000, all seine Engel.
Verse 15.
Vers 15.
To execute judgment upon all and to convince all that they are that are ungodly among them of all their ungodly deeds which they have ungodly committed and of all their hard speeches which ungodly sinners have spoken against him. So when he comes here and all the wicked die, what does Jude say? What is it?
So wenn er hier kommt und alle Bösen kommen um, was ist das?
Yes, execution of the judgment.
Das ist der Ausführung des Gerichts.
Okay, so here an execution of judgment takes place.
So hier eine Ausführung des Gerichts findet statt.
But now when we read this quote, let's read it.
Aber lasst uns diesen Zitat lesen.
So we saw Jesus leaves the sanctuary, the plagues begin to fall, the wicked die.
Verlässt den Heiligtum, Plagen fallen und den Bösen kommen.
Now in this third sentence.
Dritter Satz.
I saw that at the voice of God, the saints will be mighty and terrible as an army with banners. But they will not then execute the judgment written. So what does this White say?
So was sagt Ellen White?
So when the voice of God comes here, it is done and shakes heaven and earth.
So wenn die Stimme des Herrn kommt und sagt, es ist getan und er erschüttert Himmel und Erde.
It's not
the time to execute the judgment.
Yes.
Es ist noch nicht die Zeit, das Gericht auszuführen.
Okay, so the saints will not then execute the judgment written. Okay. But it says, but after they are changed in a moment, and in the twinkling of an eye, and are caught up with the sleeping saints, and receive the harps, crowns, etc., and enter the city, Jesus and the saints sit in judgment, the books are opened, the book of life and the book of death. Okay, so where do we enter into the city?
So wo gehen wir in der Stadt hinein?
Once you've been converted, once you've had your sins blotted out.
Yes.
Bekehrt exactly. Bist, wenn du deine Sünden ausgetilgt hast.
Okay. So.
So hier.
We enter into the city here, right?
Hier gehen wir in der Stadt ein.
Okay. So. And now it says, yeah, the saints will hold the judgment with Jesus.
Okay? Und jetzt sagt es, dass die Heiligen, die werden das Gericht mit Jesus zusammenhalten.
Okay, the point I want to make is there are two executions of the judgment. Okay.
Der Punkt, den ich hier machen möchte, ist, dass es zwei ausführende Gerichte gibt.
Okay, so let us just continue.
Lass uns weiterlesen.
Oh, why two?
We'll see. Because here's one and here's one.
Yes, so here's einer und da ist einer.
Yes, but the two points in time.
So zwei verschiedene Punkte in der Zeit.
That's not something we don't know already, though.
Did I say that's something?
No. You said the point I want to make. There's two executions of judgment, but okay. So I thought you were making some new point. But
okay. So let's continue.
So weiterlesen.
So it says here, next paragraph.
Next Absatz.
The book of life contains the good deeds of the saints, and the book of death contains the evil deeds of the wicked. So there are two books, the book of life and the book of death.
Right? Zwei Bücher, Buch des Lebens und Buch des Todes.
And these books were compared with the statute book, the Bible, and according to that they were judged. So then you have the Bible as a separate book that will basically mete out your judgment. Right?
Hast du die Bibel als eine weitere Buch, der dein Gericht bestimmen wird?
Yeah, the saints in unison with Jesus passed their judgment upon the wicked dead. Behold ye, said the angel, the saints sit in unison with Jesus and mete out to each of the wicked according to the deeds done in the body. 2 Corinthians 5:10. And it is set off against their names what they must receive at the execution of the judgment. This I saw was the work of the saints with Jesus through the 1,000 years. Okay, so during the 1,000 years, what will the righteous do?
So während der 1000 Jahren, was werden die Gerechten tun?
Yes, they will mete out the judgment that comes upon the wicked.
Also sie werden das Gericht bestimmen, was über den Bösen kommen wird.
Okay. So, let's continue.
Lass uns weiterlesen.
At the end of the 1000 years, Jesus with the holy angels and all the saints leaves the city, and while he's descending with them, the wicked dead are raised, and then the very man that pierced him, Revelation 1:7, will see him afar off in all his glory, and all the holy angels and the saints with him. Okay, so what does it say here?
Was sagt es hier?
So when Jesus comes back, what happens?
So wenn Jesus kommt zurück, was geschieht?
After the 1000 years, when
nach
he comes
den 1000
back
Jahren.
To earth. His third coming, basically.
Sein drittes Kommen, quasi.
Yes, all the wicked get raised up, right?
So all den Bösen werden auferweckt.
And who especially?
Und wer besonders?
The wicked.
Yes, those that pierced him, right?
Diejenigen, die ihn durchbohrt haben.
Revelation 1, verse 7.
Offenbarung 1, 7.
Will see him afar off in all his glory and all the holy angels and the saints with him. And what did we read earlier in this quote from GC?
Und was haben wir vorhin in diesem Zitat von Großen Kampf gelesen?
Yeah. Vorher schon mal lernen.
Yes. Yeah. At the special resurrection, right?
Bei der besonderen Auferstehung.
At the seventh plague, those that pierced him when he came the second time, they now see him coming in the glory.
Bei den siebten Plage, diejenigen, die ihn durchstochen haben, sehen ihn in seiner Herrlichkeit.
Okay, and that's now a point where I'm not fully understanding it yet. Okay.
Das ist ein Punkt, wo ich es noch nicht gänzlich verstehe.
This is typifying here, because that's also obtained. The beginning of
that's
this.
Also what I would say. Okay. Yes. So in. So, therefore, that would be marked here in this illustration.
So in dieser Darstellung, das wäre denn hier markiert.
Okay. So. This is this big ten.
Dies hier ist diese große zehn.
Yes, because when we have, for instance, here the Sunday law. Midnight.
Sonntagsgesetz, Mitternacht.
Midnight cry.
Mitternachtsruf.
And execution.
Und der Ausführung des Gerichts.
And here you have this little 10.
Hier ist diese kleine 10.
Okay, so from the midnight cry to here.
So von der Mitternachtsruf bis zu das Ende.
And do we have a 10 there?
Gibt es eine 10 da?
Yes, right. We just recently looked at some illustrations. What would be a 10 for this?
Einige Darstellungen dafür angeschaut. Was wäre denn da ein 10?
Revelation 2, 10 days.
Okay. So let's go there. Let's go to Revelation 2.
Offenbarung 2.
Let's read verse 10.
Und wir lesen Vers 10.
It says, fear none of those things which thou shalt suffer. Behold, the devil shall cast some of you into prison, that ye may be tried, and ye shall have tribulation 10 days. Be thou faithful unto death, and I will give thee a crown of life. Okay, so
that's
prison and death experience,
so,
right?
Gefängnis und Tod, diese Erfahrung in dieser Zeit.
Yes, because here you come face to face with death. It's the death decree.
Hier kommst du vor dem Angesicht des Todes, ist das Todesdekret.
And you're cast into prison like Joseph was.
Du wirst ins Gefängnis geworfen, wie Joseph es war.
The Sunday law is also 10 because it's the 4 and the 6.
Yes.
Also das Sonntagsgesetz an sich ist eine 10, so die zwei Zeiten, also ein 4 und ein 6.
Okay, so you just have it in different levels. Yes.
Ist das an verschiedenen Ebenen markiert.
Okay. So everybody can follow along?
Kann jeder mitfolgen?
So let's go back to the quote.
Zurück zur Zitat.
So let's just read the beginning of the paragraph once more.
Das Anfang des Absatzes nochmal.
So at the end of the 1000 years, Jesus with the holy angels and all the saints leave the city, and while he's descending with them, the wicked dead are raised, and then the very man that pierced him, will see him afar off in all his glory, and all the holy angels and saints with him. So here is the exact same thing.
So here is the same.
Was that pierced? Yeah. Revelation 1:7. So it's just a different level.
So it's dasselbe, nur auf einer anderen Ebene.
10 here and 10 here.
Okay. Das 10 da am Ende und das 10 hier oben.
Okay. So let's continue.
Weiter.
They will see the prints of the nails in his hands and in his feet, and where they thrust the spear into his side, and they will wail because of him. I saw that the prints of the nails and of the spear were his glory. So that's basically his third coming, you can say.
Das ist sein drittes Kommen, kann man so sagen.
Sorry. Okay, next paragraph.
Next Absatz.
Then it is that Jesus stands upon the Mount of Olives, and the mount parts asunder and becomes a plain, and the city comes down from God out of heaven and settles on the plain. Okay. So, what happens here?
Was geschieht hier? City descends.
Yes, city descends.
Okay. Der Stadt kommt herab.
And we understand at the beginning of the 10, the same thing applies, right?
Wir verstehen, dass am Anfang des Zehnes dasselbe ist angewandt.
Yeah, because, for instance, in Ezekiel chapter 1,
denn zum Beispiel in Hezekiel Kapitel 1,
what does Ezekiel see?
Was sieht Hezekiel?
The holy city.
Yes, he sees the holy city.
Er sieht das heilige Stadt.
Yes, this firmament where the throne is upon it.
Also diese Festung, auf dem der Thron sitzt.
No. Yes. Four cherubims and they have this firmament on the head.
So diese vier Cherubim mit diesem Gewölbe oder diese Firmament über ihrem Kopf.
And that's the holy city, right?
Das ist der heilige Stadt.
Okay. I think we have to make another recap on this point also. Okay. So the city descends.
So der Stadt kommt herab.
And Jesus stands on the Mount of Olives.
Und Jesus steht auf dem Ölberg.
And the mount parts asunder. What is this?
Und diesen Ölberg zerteilt sich.
Where is this taken from?
Von wo ist das genommen?
Yes, but one place is vision.
Red Sea
Cross. Zechariah 14. Okay, let's go to Zechariah 14.
Also Zechariah 14.
Let's read verse 4.
And we're reading verse 4.
It says, and his feet shall stand in that day upon the Mount of Olives, which is before Jerusalem on the east, and on the Mount of Olives that shall cleave in the midst thereof toward the east and toward the west. And there shall be a very great valley, and half of the mountain shall remove toward the north, and half of it toward the south. Right?
It's the Red Sea parting. Yes. Because it says the waters are separated.
Yes. Das Rote Meer, der sich zerteilt, denn die Wasser werden getrennt.
Yes, and they depart towards the north and to the south.
Right? Sie zerteilen sich zum Norden hin und zum Süden.
And that was also Mount Ebal and Mount Gerizim. Right?
Das war die Berge Ebal und Gerizim.
And we saw this was placed here. At the beginning of the ten, at the end of the ten.
Wir haben gesehen, dass das hier am Anfang des Zehnes der ein Berg und am Ende des Zehnes der andere markiert.
So, same would be then here in this illustration.
In diesem Fall wäre es hier und am Ende.
Okay. So, let's continue.
So, weiter.
Then Satan imbues the wicked that have been raised with his spirit, and he flatters them that the army in the city is small, and that his army is large, and that they can overcome them and take the city. While Satan is rallying his army, the saints are in the city beholding the beauty and glory of the paradise of God. So, now I have a thought. I'm not 100% sure whether this is correct, but let's look at this.
Also, ich habe einen Gedanke, den ich nicht sicher bin, 100%ig korrekt ist, aber wir schauen es jetzt an.
Okay, what is Satan doing here?
Was tut Satan hier? Gathering.
Yes, he's gathering his army, right?
Er sammelt seine Armee.
But and the saints, what are they doing at the same time?
Und den Heiligen, was tun sie zur selben Zeit?
Looking at the, just marking that point, you just said because he's gathering this same point there we in the 10 of the gathering, so he's got
Satan is gathering also.
Gathering, yes. Yes.
Also Satan sammelt, also das ist der Sammlungszeit.
So you mean it's the counterfeit gathering then?
Yes. Yes.
Also das,
so Satan gathers his host.
Eine falsche Sammlung. Satan sammelt sein Heer.
And the saints, what do the saints do?
Den Heiligen, was tun sie?
Beholding
sie God.
Yes. Behold.
The Heiligen, the garden.
Yes. Beauty and glory of the paradise of God. Right?
Also die Heiligen betrachten die Schönheit, die Herrlichkeit von Paradies.
Okay, and my thought is, as I said, I'm not 100% certain, but we understand that these boxes here, they're also the same principles you can find there. Right?
Also meine Gedanke ist, wie gesagt, ich bin nicht 100% sicher, aber diese Kasten hier im Prinzip sind dasselbe wie diese hier.
Okay, and do we have a story in here? Or rather, in this fractal here.
Und gibt es eine Geschichte in dieser Fraktal?
Where the saints behold the glory of God's kingdom.
Wo die Heiligen den Herrlichkeit Gottes Königreich betrachten. Yes. Right
At the beginning. Yeah.
So am Anfang.
Let's go to Esther chapter 1.
Lasst uns zum Esther Kapitel 1 gehen.
Let's read verses 1 to 4.
Und wir lesen die ersten vier Versen.
It says, now it came to pass in the days of Ahasuerus, that this is Ahasuerus, which reigned from India even unto Ethiopia, over 127 provinces, that in those days when the king Ahasuerus sat on the throne of his kingdom, which was in Shushan the palace, in the third year of his reign, he made a feast unto all his princes and his servants, the power of Persia and Media, the nobles and princes of the provinces being before him. And when he showed the riches of his glorious kingdom and the honor of his excellent majesty many days, even 84 days. So what does he do here in verse 3 and 4?
Was tut er hier, die Versen 3 und 4?
Yes, he shows basically the... Yes. The glory of his kingdom, right?
Er zeigt im Grunde das Herrlichkeit seines Königreichs.
So all saints that partake in this feast will see the glory and beauty of his kingdom.
Alle Heiligen, die an diesem Fest teilnehmen, werden die Herrlichkeit und Schönheit seines Königreichs betrachten.
Okay, so that was just my thought that I had, but maybe it's not, I don't know, because did we mark the 180 from here to here or from here to here?
Also haben wir die 180 von hier bis hier oder von hier bis da markiert?
Right to the beginning of the 10.
Okay.
Zur Anfang des 10.
So from here to here. Then, okay, then it doesn't really parallel, because I thought... Okay, then I had it wrong in my mind. Because when we go back to the quote,
dann wenn wir zur Zitat zurückgehen,
okay, it says here, while Satan is rallying his army, the saints are in the city beholding the beauty and glory of the paradise of God. Jesus was at the head leading them. So what do we see here? So
was sehen wir hier? Jesus war am Anfang für und führt sie.
When Jesus was at the head leading them. Yes, but I would more be inclined, it's, as we will see, it's the end of the 2300 days vision.
Also ich werde mehr dazu denken, das ist das Ende von 2300 Jahren.
Because where is Jesus leading them out a little way?
Denn wo führt Jesus sie einen kleinen Weg hinaus?
Von
Mitternacht zur Mitternacht.
Okay, that would be here, right?
Das wäre denn hier.
Yes?
Amen.
Midnight to the midnight cry. Okay.
Mitternacht zur Mitternacht.
So, and that's the little time of peace.
Das ist der kleine Zeit des Friedens.
So, he leads them out. And and what does he say here at the midnight cry?
Sagt hier an der Mitternachtsstufe?
Wait here, right?
Wartet hier.
And where does he go then?
Und wo geht er?
Yes, he goes away, right?
Er geht zum Vater.
So, now let's read here the quote again.
So, lasst uns den Zitat nochmal lesen.
Jesus was at the head leading them. So, this is now he leading them out here, okay?
So, das ist, er führt sie hier hinaus.
All at once, the lovely Jesus was gone from our company. Okay, so what happened now to him when he let them out?
So, was geschieht mit ihm, wenn er sie einen kleinen Weg hinausgeführt hat?
Yes, he disappeared, right? So he goes to his father.
Geht zu seinem Vater in diesem Sinne.
So Jesus disappears.
Jesus verschwindet.
But he says, when he goes here to the father, what does he say?
Aber wenn er zum Vater geht, was sagt er? Wait here.
Let's wait here because I will.
Wartet hier, weil ich.
Yeah, in a short while I will come back, right?
In kurzer Weile werde ich wiederkommen.
So and he comes back here, right?
Und er kommt hier wieder.
So let's read this again. All at once the lovely Jesus was gone from our company, but soon we heard his lovely voice saying, come ye blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. Matthew 25:34. So I would suggest it's right here when he again appears and speaks to them, and he says, come you blessed of my Father. Because what is he pronouncing here?
So, ich würde vorschlagen, dass es hier ist, wo er kommt und gesagt, kommt ihr Gesegnete meines Vaters, denn was ist es, was er hier verkündet?
The blessing, right?
Das Segen.
So, we understand this is the blessing.
Wir können verstehen, dass das hier der Segen ist.
Okay.
There's a point to notice, though. Yes? You went to Esther, right?
Also wir sind zum Esther gegangen.
So, at the end of that feast that he had, then they have this little 7 days feast, and at the end of it, Esther is meant to come and present herself, right?
Wir haben diese Fest von der König und am Ende gibt es diese 7 Tage lang Fest, wo Vashti hätte vor dem König kommen sollen.
So, when you go to Zechariah chapter 14.
Also wenn wir zu Zechariah 14 gehen.
Right. It's at the beginning of this. It's at the beginning of this point there, right?
Zechariah 14, yes.
This is am Anfang von Mitternachtsruf.
Which is also beginning of this little tent there, right?
Mm-hmm. Was auch gleich der Anfang dieses kleinen Szenes ist, hier und hier.
So the point is, right, when you read after that, right, it says, everybody comes up to tabernacle. So what happens is they're not in the city when the city comes down. And then they all troop up into the city. But there's another group that refused to come up into the city, right? And it tells you what happens to them right
in
there.
Zechariah 14.
Also in Zechariah 14, wenn man weiterliest.
Okay, let's go there.
Von das, was wir gelesen haben.
16.
Zechariah 14, Vers 16.
Mm-hmm. It shall come to pass that everyone that is left of all the nations which came against Jerusalem shall even go up from year to year to worship the King, the Lord of hosts, and to keep the Feast of Tabernacles. And it shall be that whoso will not come up of all the families of the earth unto Jerusalem to worship the King, the Lord of hosts, even upon them shall be no rain. And if the family of Egypt go not up and come not that have no rain, there shall be the plague wherewith the Lord will smite the heathen that come not up to keep the feast of tabernacles. This is where he pours out this final punishment. Yes.
So here's wo diese letzte Bestrafung ausgießt.
It's just like the two classes are there, the city comes down, it's again Daniel 12.
You also know, the zwei Klassen sind da. Yes. Der Stadt kommt herab und das ist wie Daniel 12, zwei Gruppen.
Right, so one group gets gathered into the city, the other group refuses to come and they get the punishment upon them.
Eine Gruppe versammelt sich in der Stadt und die andere Gruppe weigert sich zu kommen und am Ende die bekommen die Bestrafung.
Yes. So,
So Vashti is illustrating this group.
Yeah, that gets the final punishment.
That gets the final punishment.
Vashti stellt diese Gruppe dar, die diese letzte Bestrafung erhält.
So let me just get a bit of room here. Paradise. So here they look the glory of the paradise. Here Jesus leads them out a little way.
So hier betrachten sie die Herrlichkeit von Paradies. Hier führt Jesus sie eine kleine Weg hinaus wie hier.
And then this would be the midnight cry here, right?
So das hier wäre denn das Mitternachtsruf.
Yes.
Amen.
And this is now where Jesus disappears.
Das ist wo Jesus verschwindet von ihrem Sicht.
Twist?
No, maybe I'm wrong. It's too big. I always mix it up.
Okay. And this is where he then pronounces the blessing. Okay.
Und hier verkündigt er das Segen.
Okay, everybody can follow so far?
Jeder folgt.
But it's also, if you take the midnight cry below, that's where he goes to heaven. He says, I'll and likewise come back. And you just put it up there. That's where he descends.
Also hier ist, wenn er sagt, wartet hier, er geht zum Himmel und sagt, in derselbe Weise, wie ich hinaufgegangen bin, werde ich wiederkommen. Und wenn wir das hier sehen, das ist, wo er wiederkommt.
So here he goes and here he comes back.
So hier geht er hinauf und hier kommt er auf derselbe Weise wieder.
Yes, that's
it. Das ist schön, ja.
Okay, so, yeah, because this can be the midnight cry in one illustration, right?
Denn hier, das kann der Mitternachtsruf sein in einer Darstellung.
Because if you have the two Sunday laws, right?
Wenn ihr die zwei Sonntagsgesetze hättet.
Sunday law.
Sonntagsgesetz.
Final review.
Finale Untersuchung.
The middle way mark is the midnight cry.
Der mittlere right? Wegmarke wäre dann der Mitternachtsruf.
And here would be the second Sunday law.
Hier wäre dann das zweite Sonntagsgesetz.
Final review.
Finale Untersuchung.
Midnight cry.
Mitternachtsruf.
Right? So that would be then. This would be then this. Right?
So dies hier wäre dann dasselbe wie dies hier. Yes.
So the next waymark, put a waymark in the middle.
Yeah?
Yes, just put one in the middle. Yes.
Okay. So, and now he pronounces here the blessing, and what else happens?
So jetzt verkündigt er hier das Segen, und was geschieht noch?
Okay, so let us just read at the bold face again.
Jesus
was at the head leading them.
Jesus war vor sie und führte sie.
So Jesus was at the head leading them. So he's leading them here.
Er führt sie hier.
After he showed them the glory of his kingdom.
Nachdem er die Herrlichkeit seines Königreichs gezeigt hat.
All at once the lovely Jesus was gone from our company. That's now here where he says, wait here, go to my father.
Das ist hier, wo er sagt, wartet hier, ich gehe zu meinem Vater, wie hier.
But soon, because he says, after a little while I will return, okay, but soon.
Aber bald, weil er sagt, nach einer kleinen Weile werde ich wiederkommen.
And he returns.
Right? Hier kommt er wieder.
But soon we heard his lovely voice saying, come ye blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. And now it says, we gathered about Jesus. So what do they do?
Was taten sie?
The gathering
time. Sie sammeln sich um Jesus, das ist der Versammlungszeit.
So, gathering. So we gathered about Jesus, and just as he closed the gates of the city, the curse from God was pronounced upon the wicked. The gates are shut. Okay, so what happens?
Was geschieht?
Yes, doors are shut, right?
So, Tore werden verschlossen.
That's it.
Das ist es, vorbei.
So, I would... suggest that's here at the end where the doors are shut, right?
After the gathering
took place.
Ich würde vorschlagen, dass das hier am Ende ist, wo die Tore geschlossen sind, nachdem der Versammlung stattgefunden hat.
Yes. So here he gathers everybody, right? This is also in our time. It's the last call. Everybody can still be gathered, but then it's shut.
So okay. Hier versammelt jeder, also der letzte Aufruf, aber dann werden die Toren geschlossen.
And what does he pronounce?
Und was verkündigt er?
Yes, and he pronounces here the...
Es ist getan und er sagt was?
What does it say?
Was sagt es?
Yeah, the curse, right?
Das Fluch.
Okay, so here is then the curse.
Hier ist dann der Fluch.
So here he pronounced the blessing, here the curse.
Hier okay. Das Segen, hier das Fluch.
And what did we just study recently about the two mountains?
Und was haben wir über die zwei Berge neulich studiert haben? One was a blessing proclaimed and the other
was... Yes. Here was Mount Gerizim, right, which was the blessing.
Hier war das Berg Gerizim, von dem das Segen verkündigt
wurde. And here was the Mount Ebal, which was the curse.
Und right? Hier das Berg Ebal, ist das Fluch.
Okay. So now it goes on to say.
Es sagt weiter.
Then the saints use their wings and fly to the top of the wall of the city. Jesus also is also with them. His crown looked brilliant and glorious. It was a crown within a crown, seven in number. The crowns of the saints were of the purest gold and were decked with stars and shone like the sun. And as they moved all together to the top of the city. So here you have now this crown on, right?
So hier hast du jetzt diese Krone auf.
Okay. And this is, for instance, yeah, when the marriage, right? When you're married, you get the crown on.
Und das ist zum Beispiel bei der Hochzeit, wo du die Krone erhältst.
Okay. Because it says here, be thou faithful unto death. And then you get the crown of life, right?
Und es sagt, sei treu bis zum Tod ist und dann erhältst du die Krone des Lebens.
Okay. Their faces shone with glory, for they were in the express image of Jesus. Then the wicked saw what they had lost, and fire was breathed from God upon them and consumed them. Then was the execution of the judgment. Okay, so it's right here now. The fire comes down and devours them.
So gerade hier, das Feuer kommt herab und verzehrt sie.
And it says it was the execution of the judgment.
Und es sagt hier, dass das Ausführen des Gerichtes war.
Okay, so therefore we can see the fire coming down marks here the end when the judgment is executed.
Wir können sehen, dass das Feuer herabkommend ist hier am Ende, wo das Gericht ausgeführt ist.
Okay, so which is also the fire in Elijah's story, right?
Was auch das Feuer in die Geschichte von Elia auf Karmel ist.
Okay, so I hope that everybody could follow along.
So ich hoffe, dass jeder mitfolgen konnte.
And I believe that if we applied these things correctly here.
Und ich glaube, dass wenn wir diese Dinge hier richtig angewandt haben.
They give us some keys for further study.
Die geben uns einige Schlüssel, die wir benutzen können für weitere Studien.
Because it then shows that this is also this here.
Denn es zeigt uns, dass dies hier auch dies ist.
And this would be then a parallel to here, right?
Und dies wäre dann eine Parallel hierzu.
Okay, so therefore it gives us more options, let's say, to place these stories also on a bigger scale.
Und das gibt uns mehr Möglichkeiten, diese Geschichten auf eine größere Skala zu markieren.
Okay. Everybody understands?
Kann jeder verstehen?
Okay. Then I would say, then if there are no further questions or thoughts, then let's close for this evening.
Wenn es keine weiteren Fragen oder gar Gedanken gibt, dann lasst uns für heute Abend abschließen.